The microcontroller landscape has significantly changed in the past 5 years. Previously monopolized by 8-bit microcontrollers, the market is now dominated by 32-bit microcontrollers. This hardware revolution required a redesign of ArduinoJson. Once a competitive advantage of ArduinoJson 6, fixed memory allocation progressively became irrelevant. ArduinoJson 7 redefines the memory management strategy to provide an elegant and straightforward API. In this video, I'll give you an overview of what's new in this release. Before we go into the good stuff, I must warn you that ArduinoJson 7 is significantly bigger than version 6. For example, on an Arduino Uno or 3, the parser example is 41% bigger and the generator example is 45% bigger. Previously, all my design decisions were aimed at keeping the code small. Indeed, when I designed ArduinoJson 6, most users ran their programs on 8-bit microcontrollers, and that's why I focused so much on code size. That's how ArduinoJson 6 came to implement a fixed memory allocation strategy. Not only does it reduce the code size, but it also eliminates heap fragmentation and allows stack-based allocations. Fixed memory allocation is perfect when resources are scarce, but requires more discipline from the programmer. During the past 5 years, we attended to the rise of 32-bit microcontrollers, first with the ESP8266, then with the ESP32 and all the ARM-based MCUs. 32-bit microcontrollers have much more memory, but also a bigger runtime framework, so ArduinoJson now represents a small fraction of the executable. If we compare the parser example on the two versions of the Arduino Uno, we see that ArduinoJson 7 makes up about 2/3 of the executable on R3, but only 7% on R4. Because the proportion is much smaller, the difference between ArduinoJson 6 and 7 is negligible on 32-bit microcontrollers. For example, on Arduino Uno R4 Minima, the parser example only grew by 2.3% and the generator example by 1.7%. As you can see, the size of the library is not so important anymore. ArduinoJson 7 can run on 8-bit microcontrollers, but if the memory is tight, it's probably better if you stick with version 6. ArduinoJson 7 includes stubs for every deprecated feature, so most existing programs should continue to work. The stubs produce informative warning messages that tell you how to upgrade the code. Of course, since your programs continue to work, you don't have to upgrade right away, but you'll see that the process is very straightforward. I already published a video explaining the changes in detail, so I'll only give an overview here. The biggest change concerns JsonDocument. ArduinoJson 7 exclusively relies on dynamic memory allocation, and you no longer need to specify the capacity upon creation. Since we can no longer choose between stack and heap memory, I'll merge StaticJsonDocument and DynamicJsonDocument into a single JsonDocument class. To maintain excellent performance, ArduinoJson 7 reduces heap fragmentation by allocating blocks of 1 kilobyte. String deduplication also reduces the number of allocation, and a short string optimization will soon reduce it even more. The impact on heap fragmentation should be very limited. In fact, the only function that should increase the fragmentation is deserializedJSON, because it needs to reallocate blocks for strings. Because the capacity of the JSON document is now elastic, several functions related to memory management became irrelevant. JSON array size, JSON object size, JSON document capacity, JSON document memory usage, and JSON document garbage collect. JSON document shrink to fit, which releases the overallocated memory, is still available on ArduinoJson 7, but it is automatically called by disarray.json, so you probably don't need to call it anymore. I changed how we customize the allocator. Instead of passing a template parameter, you must pass a pointer to a polymorphic allocator. This change, inspired by std.pmr, allows all JSON documents to be compatible with each other, regardless of the allocator. It also allowed me to get rid of the template class basic.json.document. I managed to keep all the features of ArduinoJson 6 except one, shallow copy. Indeed, due to significant changes in the library, a slot can no longer point to a different document. If your program calls shallow copy, ArduinoJson 7 will do a deep copy instead, which could break your program, so watch out. On a different topic, I took the opportunity to remove one of the library's biggest warts. Create nested array and create nested object are a legacy of ArduinoJson 4 and they don't fit with the rest of the API. In ArduinoJson 7, I replaced them with addT and toT. Please see the upgrade guide for details. Now let's see less important changes that should only affect a minority of users and probably don't require your attention. The first is the removal of the zero copy mode. In version 6, deserialized.json behaved differently depending on the input type. If the input was a char pointer, it used a zero copy mode. Instead of copying strings into the JSON document, it kept them in the input buffer and stored pointers into the JSON document. I was initially a big fan of this feature because it could save a lot of memory. Unfortunately, the zero copy mode was misunderstood and caused many bugs, so I removed it from ArduinoJson 7. If your program relied on the zero copy mode, you'll see a significant increase in memory consumption after the upgrade. Next, I fixed the weird behavior of serialized.json with string classes. Indeed, in ArduinoJson 6, serialized.json treated string objects, such as string or std.string, as streams. So instead of replacing their content, it appended to the end. I fixed it with ArduinoJson 7. Serialized.json now overrides the content as one would expect. In theory, this is a breaking change, but I doubt it will break anything in practice. Finally, I changed the string copy policy of the serialized function. In ArduinoJson 6, row strings use the same policy as regular strings. All types were stored by copy except const char pointers, which were stored by pointers. In ArduinoJson 7, all row strings are stored by copy. I already published a new version of the ArduinoJson assistant. As you'll see, it's slightly different from what you're used to. First of all, the raison d'être of the assistant changed. Before, the main goal was to help you compute the right capacity for the JSON document. Now, it is to validate that your JSON document can fit in the RAM of your microcontroller. Consequently, step 3, which showed how much RAM you should reserve for your JSON document, was removed. The new assistant still shows the memory consumption, but this was moved to step 2 and doesn't give as many details. In addition to showing the memory consumption, the new assistant tells you what percentage of the RAM is used. Of course, this requires knowing the amount of memory available on your board, and that's why the first step now asks you to enter the board instead of the processor architecture. The new assistant still allows you to design a filter for deserialized.json, although this feature has changed a little. Instead of choosing deserialize and filter in the first step, you must now check enable input filter in the second step. The last step, which generates a sample program, remains roughly the same, except you can now customize the deserialization program. Two settings are available. The first chooses the output for the error messages, serial or stored cout, the second turns flash strings on or off. As you probably already saw, all the documentation for ArduinoJson 7 is already there. You can select the version on the navigation bar at the top of the screen. I also updated the troubleshooter to support ArduinoJson 7. You will see that it now starts by asking you which version you use. And I even included ArduinoJson 5 for completeness. If you encounter any issue with the library, please try to self-diagnose your problem with the ArduinoJson troubleshooter. If it is unable to help, please open an issue on GitHub. Remember to include the troubleshooter report in the issue description. The report gives me the context and tells me what you already tried. It also allows me to continue improving the troubleshooter by adding more choices at the right locations. I published a new edition of my book Mastering ArduinoJson for version 7. The overall structure remained the same. Chapter 1 briefly introduces ArduinoJson and what you can do with it. When updating the manuscript, I was amazed by the number of web APIs that had disappeared since the last edition. I included the list so that you realize how important it is to choose your service providers wisely. Chapter 2 teaches elementary C++ aspects that most Arduino users ignore. It's called the Missing C++ course because it covers what is usually omitted by other courses. Chapters 3 and 4 are the deserialization and serialization tutorial. They are available for free on ArduinoJson.org. Chapter 5 covers advanced topics such as filtering, deserialization in chunks, JSON streaming, allocators, readers, writers, converters, and other valuable techniques. Chapter 6 explains how the library works and how to navigate the code. I rewrote this chapter from scratch, and this version is radically different from the previous one. Chapter 7 is a troubleshooting guide. It shows how things can go wrong and how to prevent bugs. Most of this chapter applies to any C++ program, whether it uses ArduinoJson or not. Chapter 8 contains 5 case studies showing how to use ArduinoJson in different scenarios. I invite you to purchase the book directly at ArduinoJson.org/book. Not only will you learn essential things, but you'll also support my work, allowing me to continue investing a crazy amount of time in improving the library and helping the community. As you might imagine, this release has required tremendous work, so I might take a break before adding new features. If you've been following me, you know that I rarely announce what's coming in the next version. As usual, I won't make any promise about what's coming up, but I can tell you what's on my mind at the moment. First, I want to implement short string optimization, which would continue to reduce the number of allocations. Second, I hope I can rewrite the parser in a non-recursive way, which would allow me to get rid of deserialization option nesting limit and deserialization error too deep. Next, I want to add a new parser for JSON 5, which would eliminate the need for ArduinoJson enabled comments. Finally, I'll try to refactor the parsers to support incremental data, which will be fantastic for scenarios where you receive the JSON document piece by piece, like with ESP async web server. Of course, I'm not making any commitment since my priority might change. All I can promise is that I'll continue working on ArduinoJson as much as my time allows. This wraps up this video on ArduinoJson 7. I hope it answered all the questions you had about this new release. Remember that I published another video explaining how to upgrade your code from ArduinoJson 6 to 7, and I intend to create another one for ArduinoJson 5. As usual, I turned off the comments to centralize all the supports to the GitHub issues. You'll find the link in the video description. Alright, that's all. Thank you for watching.